Hi folks, this is All the Fruit, and here I have one of the most unique fruit I've ever encountered, the canistel or egg fruit. Yeah, one of the craziest fruit ever. It really tastes like egg. It tastes like boiled egg yolk, you know, when you have a hard boiled egg, or rather a soft boiled egg, and you have the yolk, which is already pretty hard. That's the exact texture and taste of Pulteria campechiana, the egg fruit. Yeah, it's even used in a lot of vegan egg recipes. Like there is a stuff called egg fruit knock, like egg knock, but with egg fruit. And yeah, in Latin America, especially in poor countries, is actually an important substitute for them. Yeah, for eggs, which are too expensive for a lot of people there to consume regularly. Very interesting plant, yeah. Pulteria campechiana, so it's in the same family as the Sapodilla and the Lucuma. The Lucuma is actually a very similar but green egg fruit. There are also some other fairly unknown egg fruits. This one and the Lucuma are the two most famous ones. The Lucuma is green, this has a much nicer color. And a much nicer taste as far as I'm concerned. It comes from Latin America, like most of those Pulteria fruit. It is quite popular for food in Latin America, but it's also grown in some other tropical and subtropical places around the world. I found it in Cambodia, I found it in Java, it's grown in Nigeria, in India, not everywhere in the tropics for some reason, but here and there. Here in Gran Canaria, it is grown, in the Canary Islands, it is grown in botanic gardens and private gardens. I've also seen it on the markets already. Here we are in a subtropical climate. Temperatures really fall below 15 degrees Celsius. And here it grows well enough. Also the Lucuma grows well enough. And the Zapote and the Sapodilla and the Mame Zapote and maybe other and many other relatives. Well, I'm really curious about the taste of those here. It's said that a lot of them don't really acquire the desired egg taste. They are bad quality cultivars and good quality cultivars. The really good ones, when almost ripe, will taste like an egg. When fully ripe, they will taste like sweet baked pumpkin. The less good ones, well, they will taste something similar to that, but not really. I picked those fruit half ripe, they were already yellowish. Then I waited for almost a week, and now the first one is almost ripe. It acquired those cracks here recently, I think, yeah, basically during the last night. Yesterday it was kind of softish, today it's soft enough, so I think now it should be in the egg yolk state. It's still not, definitely not in the sweet pumpkin state, but in the egg yolk state. Well, it already looks like egg yolk, yellow. It's not too juicy. Yeah, basically look, it has a little bit of a solid dryish consistency, like egg yolk. Like both egg yolk. Mm-hmm. Yep. Quite a good cultivar. It tastes like sweet egg yolk. Yeah. Sweet egg yolk. That's the exact description. Near the spot where the stem was attached, there was a tinge of bitterness. Maybe it's already a bit over the egg yolk state because it's quite sweet. Definitely not in the baked pumpkin state, yep. But yeah, imagine we had egg yolk with sugar. Pity. I was looking for a seed. But this is not well developed. The seeds are usually pretty large, smooth and brown. Actually, yeah, not well developed seeds might be a good thing because I guess the best varieties are propagated by grafting. So you don't really need the seeds, they just take up valuable space and you pay for them when you buy the stuff by weight. So yeah, undeveloped seeds are not a bad thing in that case. Yeah, I was afraid this fruit, which I home ripened for like a week, would not be good because I picked it half ripe, but yeah, totally happy with it. Test the consistency of sweet egg yolk. And look how dry it is. No juice coming out. I think here in the center it's getting fully ripe, so it's getting a bit more juicy. Also quite sweet, yeah? Good fruit. Folks, wherever you find such a stuff, on the market or somewhere else, get it. It's worth the money. It's a unique fruit, which I like very much. Glad I found it here in Gran Canaria. So folks, this was the... Yeah, by the way, the fruit is the most important use of the plant, but the timber is also quite good for construction. And the gum of the stems, the sap of the stems, is also used as a cheaper substitute for chicle or natural chewing gum. Chicle? Is it chicle or chicle chicle? Well, you know what I mean, the original chewing gum. So folks, this was the egg fruit or canistel, Poteria campechiana. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos on the beautiful island of Gran Canaria. And don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe.